order to welcome our guests who are highly distinguished academicians and educators. Professor Diksha, please.
Very warm welcome to all of you. I hope I'm audible to all. Very good morning. And all present here from India and out of India, it's my great pleasure to welcome you all and present my welcome song, which is composed, and I will be singing this for you. You all are welcome, it's hearty welcome, I welcome you all. You all are welcome, it's hearty welcome, I welcome you all. Was waiting for you just for this morning. Was waiting for you just for this morning. I welcome you all. I welcome you all. Welcome you all. Welcome. We quarantined since COVID-19, working from home though. We are quarantined since COVID-19, working from home though. All should be safe here, everyone's prayer. All should be safe here, everyone's prayer. I welcome you all. I welcome you all, welcome you all, welcome. As birds are chirping, as stars are shining, just for this morning. You all are here, beautiful sphere. You all are here, beautiful sphere. I welcome you all. I welcome you all, welcome you all, welcome. My days were busy, just went on crazy. What a happy moment. My days were busy, just went on crazy. What a happy moment. Seems to be closer. Everyone gathered. Seems to be closer. I have come. I welcome you all, welcome you all, welcome. I welcome you all, welcome you all, welcome. I welcome all, you all, welcome. Once again, I welcome you and the best to all of you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Nawlesar, for providing me opportunity to present here my welcome song. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Diksha. It is wonderful. Superb, mind-blowing melody tagged to present pandemic and lockdown context. Thank you. Now I request our principal, the chief organizer, Dr. Vinayak Jadhav, for his welcome speech. Honorable Dr. Jadhav, sir, please.
Principal sir, you are requested to open your microphone, that is unmute, please. Yes.
Professor Chetan, welcome.
Is it okay, sir?
Yes, okay. Proceed.
Good morning from Shivaji Mahavidyalaya Udgal, Maharashtra, India, to all the dignitaries, participants and reviewers. Of this kind, two-day international conference on the role of literature in the time of crisis like coronavirus pandemic, organized by our English department in collaboration with Swami Ramanand Tirth Marathwada University, Nanded. I extend warm welcome to all of you. I welcome Honorable Chairperson Professor Sri Vijay Kumar J. Patil Shirolkar, President of Kisan Shikshan Prasarak Mandal Udgir. Honorable Sri Jnanadevji Jhodge Guruji, Secretary Kisan Shikshan Prasarak Mandal Udgir. Inaugural Chief Guest, Honorable Dr. Uddharoji Bhosle Sir, Vice Chancellor of Swami Ramanand Tirth Marathwada University, Nanded, Maharashtra. Chief Guest and Speaker, Honorable Professor Dr. Ami Upadhyay, Vice Chancellor of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Open University, Ahmedabad, Gujarat. Honorable Professor Dr. Chetan Trivedi, Vice Chancellor of Bhakt Kavi Narsimha Mehta University, Junagadh, Gujarat. Special invite is Honorable Professor N.D.R. Chandra, former Vice Chancellor of Bastar University, Chhattisgarh. Honorable Dr. M. Maniruddha, Professor, Department of English, Jahangir Nagar University, Dhaka, Bangladesh. Honorable Dr. Ampat Poshai, Faculty, Department of English, Jazan University, Saudi Arabia. My colleague and all the participants and reviewers on Zoom and YouTube live. Conference is a celebration of knowledge. Currently, the entire world is plagued by the COVID-19 epidemic. We need the cooperation and active participation of all to overcome this global crisis. As per the guidelines issued by the Government of India, we are working from home and this event is one of it. You must have read about our town, about management, about our college and organizing department.
Now audible, please.
Okay. Thank you. Now I would like to request our one of chief guests, an artist by passion and a noted academician turned administrator by profession, Honorable Professor Dr. Ami Upadhyaya, Vice Chancellor of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Open University, Ahmedabad, Gujarat. Professor Dr. Ami ma'am specializes almost all genres of literature. Her books on English language and its usage, the Indian poetics, mastering English, Gujarati literature, as well received in academia. I request her for her talk, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. Ami Upadhyaya.
Namaskar. Honorable President Sir, equally Honorable Secretary Principal, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Bhakt Kavi Narsimha Mehta University, Junagadh, and dear friend Professor Chetan Trivedi Ji, Dr. Navle, all academicians associated today with this virtual platform. Good morning to all of you. I know that the morning is not that good because we are surrounded by a very difficult situation where we talk about crisis of pandemic. But it's a human nature, and I would go still a further step, that the nature of a teacher who always believes in optimism and believes in singing and dancing in whatever the situation. Because if after storm, birds can sing, why can't we? Today, when we are discussing about the role of literature in the time of crisis, pandemic like pandemic coronavirus, I think I'm reminded of, you know, as P.B. Shelley, who says that our sweetest are the song of those songs. They are often, they tell about the saddest situations. It's a vice versa, that crisis have produced the best literature. And the best literature has always helped people in the crisis. First of all, it is very important for all of us to understand the wider meaning of literature. Literature is not simply something in black and white. The movie is literature. Today, the social media memes, they are also literature. Literature, the meaning of literature at extended is to be understood first. When we talk about crisis, crisis is a situation that frightens us, that creates huge fear within us. Pandemic means something pan that affects more than a person, maybe affecting huge community across the country or maybe globe. And there's literature, pan-literature, because literature also affects, touches hearts of people across country or maybe across globe. So first of all, it is very important to understand whether when talk about crisis, pandemic, literature is pan-literature. So this is something very common between both of them. In time of crisis, the nature of human being, mankind, is to cling to some hope for survival, that we will survive. Who will tell us that we will survive? Maybe when we are kids, we fall down. Our parents say that when we were young, we used to fall down. We would, you know, stand up and we would start walking again. it doesn't harm. The harm or injury is not forever. One comes out of it. But when the situation crisis like coronavirus pandemic is there, me, my neighbor, my neighboring state, my neighboring country, when all of us are affected, all of us are frightened, who would soothe us? Who would console us? Yes, the soul minds from the books, from the literature would come forward to soothe us, to console us. The motivation, inspiration, the ray of hope for survival, we will get from the books and literature. Day before yesterday, Ahmedabad Mirror, the newspaper, reported a very beautiful full-page article that the best poems are coming from this pandemic situation. Now you see, this is the literature born of pandemic. I'm reminded of Anne Frank's diary. When we read it, we feel that no, if people could survive in that situation, we will survive in this situation. I'm reminded of a movie like Castaway, which talks that a single human being with a strong hope for survival, strong urge to survive, really survives, because that hope, that urge makes him survive. When we talk about the time of crisis, present situation, I think literature plays a vital role. When we read literature of survival, literature of hope, we are convinced that we would also survive. The research says across globe that maximum domestic violence is found during the time of lockdown. Why? Because people are suppressed, they are oppressed, they are depressed. And anyhow, they want to take out their depression, their frustration, and the women and the hopes, and no, they are the victimized for this domestic violence. The reason that that suppressed tensions, fear, frustration require some catharsis. We know it very well that literature plays vital role in catharsis. Maybe while reading some book, that frustration, depression comes out as fear, as tears, as laughter, or maybe somewhere console. In that situation, again, that cases of domestic violence, cases of suicide, cases of depression would be lesser because literature would save them. When we talk about Indian poetics, it talks about rasa nishpatti, navras and rasa nishpatti. The final destination of any literature or any art is rasa nishpatti. Rasa nishpatti is effective and it reaches to a final destination, gantavya sthan, when the viewer is saridaya. Saridaya means when I read literature, when I watch a movie, so that piece of literature or maybe piece of art, performing art, literature, drama, I'm able to relate it to my feelings, whatever is going on within my mind, within my heart, and I am able to relate it. Mankind, human being, they are social. They are social, and this sociability, they need to connect themselves with the other people. So this relatability is very important. Now you see, when I am locked among the four walls, I am fearing to touch a person or to approach a person. I'm avoiding to meet people. The social being within me is getting suffocated. When we read literature, with the help of literature, I'm able to establish that social relatability. I'm able to, you know, connect with the society. I read the characters, I meet the characters, I meet the situation. When the character is, you know, enjoying social gatherings somewhere, I'm able to enjoy my social being through that character. So in this way, really, literature plays a very vital role. As it is inaugural session, I'm sure that 2 days
would be very fruitful discussions that would result into something very concrete as maybe a proceeding book and would reach to many viewers. And there is a possibility the whole book or these 2 days conference would be a kind of research output of 3 months that the society community that has been facing. I really wish all the best, and I congratulate also Dr. Navle and his whole team for organizing such a wonderful conference. Wish you all the best. And I thank you all for inviting me here and making me a part of this conference. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Ami Upadhyay. During the course of your talk, three vice chancellors joined in our webinar. First, I would like to welcome my vice chancellor of my university, Honorable Professor Dr. Uddhav Bhosle. Namaste, sir. My friend and vice chancellor, Dr. Chetan Vedi, welcome. And also former vice chancellor, Professor Dr. NDR. Now I would like to request another chief guest, Professor Dr. Chetan Dwivedi, a very young vice chancellor of Bhakta Kavi Narasimha Mehta University, Junagadh, Gujarat, who specializes in ICT in education, Gandhian literature, critical theories, communication skills, Canadian literature and cultural studies. He was gold medalist at MA English from Bhavnagar University. I request him for his talk. Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. Chetan Kumar Nandalal Dwivedi.
Very good morning to all of you. It is indeed a pleasure to be there in the galaxies of the vice chancellors. See, this is possible only because of these web conferences. It is very difficult to call a single vice chancellor, and here we can see 3 or 4 vice chancellors together. It's a great pleasure and privilege to be there with this academic gathering. Respected Vijay Kumar Patil ji, the president of this trust, and the secretary, Honorable Vice Chancellor Bhosle ji, and our Gujarat Prime Vice Chancellor Ami Upadhyay ji, then some other guests like Chandra ji, Jogge ji, Manijuram ji, Kaushi ji, and Navle ji, and so many of us. Because see, this is a kind of gathering. We all pass through different kind of situations. This corona has taught us a lot. When it started, we never knew what are the new things will come to us. And even today, we are unaware about who our enemy is, what to do, what not to do. In certain kind of uncertainties, this human species has shown a tremendous courage to fight against it. That shows the virtue and the victory of the humanity. In such days, education and education department has not stopped a single day. We, being a teacher, always feel that we are not common people. We have always done something better for the betterment of the society, human being, people, and all. Today, especially, give my congratulations to the entire team of Navle ji and the university and the management and the college and the concerned people. We are meeting through a different kind of platform. The name itself suggests it's a web conference. When we say web conference, see this, when we are talking, we all are the people of literature. I was just wondering in the morning that there are so many new words came to us. Web conference, work from home, webinars, lockdown, quarantine, home quarantine, sanitizers, Zoom, WebEx, etc. So these are the new terminologies. This is going to take place in the literature in new coming days, I tell you. The poems will be written on such topics and such themes. So this is also a one point to take for the new researchers. Now, this platform, if you take an administrative way, some vice chancellors are also with me, they can think in different direction. If you have to organize such kind of web conference, having different 9 sessions, more than 300 to 400 participants, 2 days program, so many guests and chairperson, it will cost minimum 10, 15 lakhs rupees. Here we can see that, see how people are together with us in a crystal clear voice and clarity of thoughts and ideas. So in a way, it's a new paradigms, new mode of education. We all have started jumping into it. We all have started doing into it. And as a researcher, as an admin head or academic head, what we could do is, I would like to share one good story of government of Gujarat. Recently, yesterday, the chief minister of Gujarat has released scholarship for the PhD scholars. They're supposed to get 15,000 rupees per month. And ultimately, by the end of PhD, they will get 4 lakhs rupees for the novel ideas and the thoughts. And equally, in our university also, we have started a new platform for the young researchers and scholars. So now, this new era has been there. New themes are there. New topics are there. New condition is there. In that scenario, it is the role and the duty of the academicians to provide a proper and the new bigger platform that is matching to the situations and condition. So that Gujarat government has taken a nice initiative and more than some 400 students received the scholarship. And now other students are also going to receive. The same can be done by our other universities also. So this is what a kind of need is. This webinar, I'm sure Dr. Navle, I have been knowing him since long, he's a friend of mine. And he is doing wonderful work. Now, this webinar will end with some books or publications with some ideas and some new knowledge or some new projects. As we all are doing that, even our Ami Upadhyay madam, she's also doing wonderful work in Gujarat. She has started a series of webinars where she has joined more than 2 lakhs of people in single platform. So this is what a new era where web conferences are doing, some new researches are done. So the earlier platform of research has already been changed. We have divided the time into the 3 different parameters, before corona, during corona, and after corona. We need to understand it very clearly. We need to understand it very minutely. And whatever we are doing, it should not stop to the experiments only. It should concern to the concern of the humanity, concern of the people, concern of the literature, and being a man of literature. So literature has always been a mirror of society. All the literary artists are always trying to put or give some inputs to the society. Or it may be the imaginations, which is beyond the realism of society. In every case, now it is a new topic or new subject. I wish all the people, those who have been associated, I am using the word associated with the success of the web conference. I congratulate them. I give my regards to them. I also wish all the best to the young researchers and scholars, those who have been presenting their papers, because the program is for them. We are the only people will come and talk and will go. But ab tumhare hawale watan saathiyo, you have to think. You have to put, you have to give, and ultimately you are the best feedback for the development of the country and nation. Once again, I am very thankful to Dr. Navle ji and the entire team that I am here placed among the galaxies of the Vice Chancellor. Once again, thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Dwivedi. Thank you. Now I request our special invitee, Honorable Professor Dr. N.D.R. Chandra, former Vice Chancellor, Bastar University, Chhattisgarh. I will give his detailed introduction in his keynote session, which will follow after this session. Dr. N.D.R. Chandra, sir, I request you, due to paucity of the time, just share your message or greetings on this session, because you have a keynote session after this session. Dr. Chandra, please.
I am delighted to be part and parcel of this great event. And I express my thanks and gratitude to the college community, and especially my thanks goes to Mr. Navle for inviting me for this event. In fact, this seminar is, you know, touching the time. And in fact, we are in great crisis, and we are, you know, facing a lot of difficulties. Corona has given a new dimension, and we are facing a lot of troubles. We are in confinement. We are using masks in our face. We are in quarantine, and a different kind of lifestyle we are adopting. The need of the hour is to restructure our lifestyle to face the challenges of tomorrow. I would like to quote a line from an anonymous poet घर गुलजार सुने शहर बस्ती बस्ती में कैद हर हस्ती हो गई आखिर जिंदगी महंगी हो गई और दौलत सस्ती हो गई. See, homes are blooming with fear. The cities are paralyzing in settlements and suburbs. Confined everywhere, human being, the life has become costly again, and property has become cheaper. We have seen the scenario that how we are throwing in books. And it is of no use for them. This money and currency could not save their life. Crisis is a critical point of time. And we are quite hopeful that we will overcome the crisis. And in this time of crisis, we have seen that in the Middle Ages, there were black deaths. And in those black deaths, after that, it led to the Renaissance and reawakening. So after this, a great, you know, crisis, we are quite hopeful that we will see a good day in the future. The last thing I would like to say that literature and life, they are interrelated. We visualize the thing through literature. Literature informs us. It helps us to understand the society. And in fact, we need the role of literature during this pandemic.
I request Professor time, Chandra, please.
Just last line. The role of literature has got tranquilizing effect so that we can change our lifestyle and we can meet the challenges. I wish a great success for this.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Chandra.
Thank you.
And I request our another special invitee, Dr. M. Manrizuddam, Professor, Department of English, Jahangirnagar University, Dhaka, Bangladesh. I will give his detailed introduction in his keynote session, of which he is the chairperson. Professor, please, I request to put your say within just 2 minutes, sir, please.
Thank you very much. Do you hear me?
Yeah, yes, yes, you are audible.
Yeah. Respected chairperson of the inaugural session, honorable chief guest, honorable special guests, honorable guests of honor, learned speakers and presenters, enthusiastic audience, ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum, namaskar, good morning. I feel honored to be invited here today. It's COVID-19 time. We are now in an unprecedented state. We all across the globe have stress, tension, anxiety, apprehension, fear, uncertainty. As Shelley says, I fall upon the thorns of life, I bleed. However, we are still alive. We still lead our life. Let's maintain social distance, be health conscious, abide by health rules, cooperate with each other, stay safe and bloom. Again, Shelley says, if winter comes, can spring be far behind? Everything is changing. We are already in a changed world. Radical change will affect our mindset, thought, policy, activity, economy, education, communication, and so forth in the months after COVID-19 pandemic. There is no return to yesterday, so institutions and individuals need to commence from first principles, entering a post-coronavirus world, not in isolation, but in communication, cooperation, and collaboration. This international web conference is a unique one. So far as I'm aware, such a virtual conference on the role of literature in the time of crisis like pandemics has first been organized in this part of the world, that's Maharashtra, India. I am really grateful to the organizers. Though sounding opposite, the role of the time of crisis like coronavirus pandemic in literature can have some sort of link to today's conference too. However, this conference means a lot during this trying time. I believe we'll gain precious insights and information from the speakers, presenters, and participants researching literature in a time of crisis like coronavirus pandemic. Last but not least, I'm very happy to thank SRTM University, Shivaji Mahavidyalaya, the organizers of the conference, especially Principal Dr. Binayak A. Jadav and Dr. Arvind M. Nawale, and their capable team for their noble thoughts, innovative ideas, great endeavors invested in creating this platform for academicians, educators, researchers, practitioners, scholars, teachers, students, and enthusiasts.
Thank you, sir.
I do hope, just 1 minute, I do hope this event will be insightful, fruitful, and meaningful, and thus enlighten us during this crisis period of COVID-19 pandemic and make implications for our action in the time to come after the crisis is over. I truly believe and wish this conference will be a big success. Thank you for inviting me here. Hope to be with you all through this event. See you. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Now I would request Honorable Dr. Anpad Kosi, Department of English, Jazan University, Saudi Arabia. He is presently working in the English Department of Jazan University. He has many books, degrees, diplomas, certificates, prizes, and awards to his credit. And also, besides teaching, he is an editor, anthology maker, poet, critic, and writer of fiction. He runs an autism NPO with his wife, Anna Gabriel. Dr. Anpad Varghese Kosi, please. Only 2 minutes, please.
Thank you. At the very outset, I would like to thank the able Dr. Nawale for giving me this wonderful opportunity to address such an august audience. I don't know how to thank him enough, and indeed cannot ever thank him enough. In fact, that he thought me worthy of it, letting me be part of such a felicitous occasion. I am extremely happy and honored to be part of the SMU International Event Conference or Zoom webinar. As far as I know, it is the first of its kind in the world and the need of the hour. So I am overjoyed, in fact. Heartfelt congratulations to the university for hosting it, having as theme the topic that needs to be dealt with now. The only university having gone ahead and done it. As this kind of initiatives will definitely be the shape of the future. And this becomes thus a great and even definitely a historic moment. My respects unbounded are also offered at this moment by me to all the honorable and eminent distinguished personalities and colleagues on the virtual dais with me. The vice chancellors, the professors, the presidents, the secretaries, the principal, all of you. And 38 or 39 resource persons who are going to make presentations or give talks in this international webinar. And all who are listening and participating from places as far-flung as the USA, Cameroon, Saudi Arabia, Bangladesh, Pakistan, India, etc., making it a grand and truly international event. I hope that many ideas about the relevance of literature in the time of crisis, when there is a global crisis like a pandemic, which the COVID-19 is, come up during this conference, that it is thrown up. And I hope that we have an excellent time. Thank you all once again, because this is going to help society, people, the nation, and the whole world, what comes up in this conference.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Kosi. The next segment of this session is inaugural speech by Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. Uddhav Bhosle, Vice Chancellor of our parent university. He is PhD from IIT Mumbai. Before joining our university as the youngest Vice Chancellor, he was a principal at MCT's Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Technology, Mumbai, a leader in technical education in the state of Maharashtra, imparting quality engineering education. He was technical director of Vilas Rao Deshmukh Foundation and Mandra Charitable Trust Latur. He visited different countries, including United Kingdom, as part of his academic pursuit. He is known for his punctuality, command over ICT, rich quality research output, down-to-earth nature, and his love for innovations in higher education and university administrative reforms. For your information, he and our Pro Vice Chancellor sanctioned our conference proposal and sent approval within 24 hours, though university headquarters Nanded was under lockdown and curfew that time. Sir, I'm happy to share that we received a 365 authentic registrations from almost all states and union territories of India and more than dozens of foreign countries. Here, in 2 days meet, approximate 25% of those persons are from abroad. We are making this online conference truly international and a mega event. I request him for his much awaited inaugural talk and guide, motivate fraternity who are accessing this event from all corners of the world through Zoom and YouTube Live. Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. Uddhavji Bhosle, sir.
Very good morning to one and all. Dignitaries on this virtual dais, Sri Vijay Kumar Patil Sahib, President Kishan Shikshan Prasarak Mandal Udgir, Honorable Sri Nandyo Jode, Secretary Kishan Prasarak Mandal Udgir, Honorable Sri Ami Upadhyayji, Honorable Sri Chetan Trivedi, Honorable NDR Chandra, then Honorable Dr. Amit Kosho, then Principal of this Institute, Sri Dr. Vinayak Jadhav, convener of this workshop, the convener of this 2 day international conference, Sri Dr. Arvind Naule, participant, resource person, ladies and gentlemen. It is my indeed privilege and great honor to be a part of this August gathering. I extend my thanks to the authorities of institutions, particularly Principal Dr. Vinayak Jadhav and his team for extending me the invitation to inaugurate this truly international conference. I take this opportunity also to congratulate Professor Vinayak Jadhav and his team for organizing this wonderful international conference, which is in need of ours today. On the behalf of university, on my own behalf, I extend my best wishes for the success of this conference, and I hope that this conference would be a successful one, and it successful in terms of an outcome based. As you are aware that COVID-19 has created so many challenges, so many problems, not only in the area of education, but in all spheres of our life. I personally feel that these challenges we must convert into an opportunities. So definitely this international conference will convert these challenges into an opportunity and send a positive message among the society to come out of this COVID-19 crisis. Thank you. Once again, I thanks authorities and extend my congratulations and extend my best wishes. Thank you. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for official inauguration of this mega international summit and your guidance. Now we are at concluding part of the session. I request Honorable Sri Vijay Kumar Patil, alias Nana, President of our KSP Mandal Udgir, to make chairman comments and preside over the function.
Sir, you will have to unmute your mic. Honorable President, sir.
Unmute mic. Anis? Nana's mic. Unmute. Yeah.
Hello.
Yes, yes, please.
Yes. The chief guest of inauguration of this international MAHIP conference, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of SRT Marathwada University Nanded, Professor Dr. Uddhavji Bhosle sir, chief guest of and speaker, honorable vice chancellor of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Open University, Ahmedabad, Gujarat, Professor Dr. Ami Padhyay, honorable vice chancellor of Bhakt Kavi Narsimha Mehta University, Jahangir, Junagadh, Gujarat, Professor Dr. Chetan Trivedi ji, special invitees, honorable Professor Dr. NDR Chandra, former vice chancellor, Bastar University, Chhattisgarh, honorable Dr. M. Maninazuddin, professor, Department of English, Jahangir Nagar, the University of Dhaka, Bangladesh, honorable Dr. Amit Khosi, faculty, Department of English, the Jahan University, Saudi Arabia, our my colleague, Sri Dandevji Jodge sir, secretary KSP Bandar Udgir, principal Dr. Vinayak Rao Jadhav, convener of this the conference, and the head of the Department of English, Dr. Arvind Dawale, and all participants. I am delighted to and honored the eminent to have you like it, all dignitaries and participants from all the corners of the world here with us on behalf of Kisan Shikshan Prasar Mandal and Shivaji College Udgir. I am thankful to all of you. First time in the history of the region, this type of the online international conference is organized by our college, and we received hug response of around 300 participants from almost all over India and some from US and UK also. Today the whole world is facing a very critical time of the crisis caused by coronavirus outbreak. The literature is said to be the mirror of the society. How the literature projected such pandemic took place in the past, and what would be its role to face such time of the crisis is the topic of this conference. As per my information, our institution is one of the institution to organize the conference on this topic. I am very happy to listen all resource persons of the inaugural session and see you all have, and I am sure that would be the fruitful discussions in 2 days. Once again, I give it my hearty wishes to this conference.
Thank you. Now I will my colleagues to propose the program of this wonderful session. Dr. Gutte.
Good morning, everyone. It's been a very nice inaugural session and web conference on the role of literature in the times of coronavirus pandemic. I take this opportunity to first thank you to the Vice Chancellor, SRTMU Nanded, Honorable Uddhav Bhosle sir, for inaugurating this web conference. He has always been encouraging us for his thorough support to conduct this activities, and this is only possible because of his permission and the efforts of our team. Second, I would like to thank Honorable President of KSP Mandal, Honorable Sri Vijay Kumar Ji Patil sir, the President of KSP Mandal, to permit us to conduct this web conference. And I'm also thankful to Honorable Nandev Jodge sir for supporting us continuously, and because of his permission and support, we could make this conference possible. I take this opportunity, I'm also grateful to Honorable Professor Dr. Ami Upadhyay, Vice Chancellor Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Open University. She has been very great speech or talk on this occasion of this web conference. Thank you, madam. And I'm also thankful to Dr. Chetan Trivedi, Vice Chancellor Bhaktakavi Narsingh Mehta University, Junagadh, Gujarat. He has also been a very good talk on this occasion, on this web conference. I would like to thank NDR Chandra sir, former Vice Chancellor, Bastar University, for his talk. I also thankful to Dr. Manirajam, Professor, Department of English, Jahangir Nagar University, Dhaka. I take this opportunity to thank Ampat Koshi from Jajan University, Saudi Arabia. I also extend my vote of thanks to the principal of our college, Dr. Vinayak Dadav sir, for his commitment and for his support to conduct this and to this support, for his support of this conference. I also want to thank to Dr. Diksha Kadam for wonderful welcome song. I'm also thankful to the convener and the head of the department, Dr. A.M. Nawle sir, for his tireless effort to conduct such a great and wonderful conference in the time of pandemic. I also thank to IQAC coordinator, Dr. V.M. Pawar sir, for his support. My heartfelt thanks to all valued online participants without whom this conference might not be possible. And I also thank to all the participants who are participating on not only on the Zoom, but they are also participating from all over the world on YouTube Live. I also thank to all our teaching and non-teaching staff. I also want to thank the technical team to make this event possible. Thank you, one and all. Thank you very much.
Thank you. All four vice chancellors remain up for the last moment of this session. We, on behalf of the KSP Mandal and Shivaji Mahavidyalaya, we are highly grateful toward you. Thank you. I am closing the session. Thank you.